Verse 5 continues on, and it says this. The woman, we're going to change direction a little bit, shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man, neither shall a man put on a woman's garment, for all that do so are abomination unto the Lord thy God. And so this one is not that unclear, actually. No, it's basically and clearly presenting that there is a clothing article that belongs to a man and there are clothing articles that belong to women. You're not supposed to wear that which pertaineth unto another. Now, my position on this, and first of all, it's way easier generally in the day that we live in to just decide this upon a man. If you see a man dressed up as a woman, you can tell it right away. Whereas women's clothing, it's started to blend the lines, hasn't it? There's clothing articles that are drawing lines and blurring lines, and it's not clear and distinct. Now, if a man comes out in high heels and a dress and lipstick on, you're like, whoa, freak! Like that is abomination. He is abomination. But then there's women that come out and maybe like a pantsuit that looks just like mine, and people have blurred the lines and said, okay, well, that's okay. Well, what makes that okay but not the other? And I would say, though, when it comes to this area of judgment, that people need to come to their conclusions based on not through the compulsion of men, but by the compelling of God or conviction of spirit, okay? So my experience was that when my wife was saved, I was saved a little bit before her, and I had already learned some of these truths. But I mean, we were saved from the old world, as worldly as it gets, the rock and roll lifestyle. And so she had a closet full of tight blue jeans, right? Okay, now I didn't wisely go in there and just start taking these things and throwing them out and saying, you're going to dress this way from now on and enforcing myself. But rather, I had to give place for God to work that into her life. And then one day she comes to me and she's like, hey, in my closet, I have all of these things that I don't feel are right for me to wear. Will you help me to draw them out and to dispose of them? And I was happy to do so, of course, but that was by the compelling of God and the conviction of the Spirit, and not by the compulsion of men. Not just because somebody told her to do so, not just because someone mandated that would be the case. No. When God makes a change in a person, especially when it comes to something so personal as their attire, because honestly, we say a lot about ourselves by what we wear, don't we? You were talking about that the other day when you're in the bus station. People came and talked to you and they're like, this man must be a churchgoer. He must be a Christian. Well, why did they say that? Was it because of his haircut? Was it because of his like slightly scruffy beard or what? No, it was because he was in a suit on a Sunday, right? His attire said something about him. And this is what attire needs to do. And this is why it's like not wear that which pertaineth unto a man and not wear that which pertaineth unto a woman if you're that opposite sex. Because it ought to be clear what you are and who you are. There ought to be a clear and present distinction. And the Bible is clear here that all that cross those lines and cross dress are an abomination. Look at the end of that verse. It says, for all that do so are abomination unto the Lord thy God. It doesn't say that what they're doing is abomination. It says that they are abomination. Okay? A guy with a beard and a dress, okay? That's abomination. That's clear to people, right? Lady in a pantsuit, maybe that's not all clear. But this is where I think the distinction biblically is, okay? The clearest item that is clearly for man and clearly for woman is made plain on the washroom doors, isn't it? Right? We know which washroom to go to because there's a triangle shaped like a dress and then there's a straight legs for the man, okay? Now, I would say that's the clearest distinction, okay? That's just black and white. We don't find gray area when we go to the washroom doors, do we? It's just black and white. It's very clear. Now, that's the bottom line distinction, but I would say also that there's some gray area, and even culturally speaking, because I saw at the park the other day as I was meditating upon these things, some Indian ladies that were out, and they were wearing a long coat and these pants things that went way out and flowed, and you could, unless you looked, you couldn't tell that there was material on both legs. But I didn't look at them and say, oh, they're wearing that which pertaineth unto a man. You know what I mean? The Indian garb for their ladies, it looks very feminine. It looks very nice. It looks very pretty. But it is what we would call pants, I believe, right? There's a distinction there, though. You know what I mean? And so while I believe that the easiest distinction, okay, men wear pants, women wear dress, I believe that there's also some lines. But, okay, when it comes to serving God and when it comes to the commandments of God, he is often black and white. And so we need to make sure that our heart is right in this. And this is why I say that this has to be the compelling of God and the conviction of the Holy Spirit. Some people, some women wear pants in the house. Some people wear pants when they go and do certain tasks, okay? I'm not getting on people for what they have worked out with God, but it's got to be worked out with God. And we want to make sure that in no case are we graying the area, right? No case are we kind of, I don't know, is that the clothing of a man? Is that the clothing of a woman? I don't know. I mean, you just want to make sure that it's clear and it's distinct. Because this is the thing that is a big problem in our society, is blurring the lines. Who's the head of the house? Who should be leading? Who should be in charge? Who should be caring for the children at home? Who is in charge of each area of the home? Even the home itself is in under attack, right? We have women stealing the kids and then trying to rule the house because they got a divorce and they won the settlement, and they, you know, now they're the boss of the own house, but they're putting the kids in don't care, and they're wearing the pants when they go to the good job so that they can care for them, right? And then we have the men that just want to sit at home and play video games and be the stay-at-home dad while the wife goes off and does those things. And there's so many lines that are being blurred these days, so we want to be clear, okay? And the Bible here, I believe, is very clear. It's as clear as the washroom door, okay? Not meaning to be graphic, but it's clear. Don't wear that which pertaineth unto a man, neither shall a woman put on a man's garment. A man shall not put on a woman's garment. You just got to make sure that distinction is clear. Why? Because God is clear. Look at that command and that charge at the end. All that do so are abomination. I don't want to tread the line of being an abomination unto God. So I'm just going to make sure that whatever I'm wearing, I'm pleasing unto him.